Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Spyro the Dragon Reignited. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we blitzed our way through high caves and dealt with those terrifying metal spiders. And today, what I'm hoping to do is go on to the next world. I think it's called Wizard Peak, if I'm not mistaken. Sort of like, for me, it was always a non-event of a world when I played it in the original. It was sort of one of the levels that you always forget about. Like, if you think of other levels in Spyro which are more memorable, like the first worlds, and then the flight levels, and then you've got the one with the spiders and treetops, and then this one just seems to be a bit kind of bad, really. Anyway, let's get stuck into the game. Right, but first we need to make our way through this place without getting killed. He nearly killed me there. Right, and we also need to find a key. Which I'm sure we'll find. Right, hello. Crystal flight. No, we don't need to do crystal flight just yet. Like, we always do that second to last. Because our firemen are most stressful. Right. Bola! It's so old!
This portal leads to a special place where you can learn to fly. I remember when I was a young dragon, earning my wings.
Learn to fly. Got it.
Respect your elders. Man. Oh, what was I going to say? I need the charger. What was I going to say? No, not the electric guys. I was going to say something, but I forgot. Oh, I was going to say that guy reminded me of Brian Blessed. You noticed the voice. I talk like this! That was a very shit Brian Blessed impersonation. Forgive me. Right, Wizard Peak, that's our next part of call then. Just get this chest here, otherwise I'll forget it. So let's go get stuck into Wizard Peak. Yeah, it's a neat ability being able to control Spyro in these loading screens to an extent, but my god, once the gems are piling up, it really doesn't like the frame rate. It's like, no, stop making me do three things at once. Please. Whoosh. Right, Wizard Peak. No, this is not the one with the, what is this one? I don't have no... I'm like Gandalf here. I have no memory of this place. Oh, that was close. Did he actually get me there? Or was Sparks always blue? Blue gem on blue floor. Thanks, game, you cheeky. Oh, this is the one where I can never figure out how to make my way around. Because I know there's a really finicky glide you've got to do to get to the effective outside of this place. And I think it might be a blind one as well, but I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. And the enemies here have got a really pain in the ass attacks. Wow. I am down a Sparks, man. This level is ramped up, man. This feels way more difficult than the original. Maybe that's because I came in here with blue Sparks. Oh, save point. Oh, mind if I do. Rescue Jarvis.
Welcome to Wizard Peak. This is my favorite supercharged spot. Use it to bash those wizards.
Oh, yes, of course. This is the one with these superchargers. I'm not sure why I need to supercharge these. I just blame them, you know? Right, and finally, you get these two things. There we go. Right, and I know there's a supercharge jump that I need to do here. I think I missed every single one. There we go. I did. Up and down. These wizards must be horrible. This is like a horror film. You know when you see, like, in a horror film, like, a pack of, a group of adventurers going through a forest, and then one by one they start getting, dragged away by some really fast, unseen enemy. It must be like that for them. Alright, I definitely need to get that, chest. Hello, Hexus.
Well done, Spyro. Thank you for releasing me.
You still say thank you for releasing me just because you fluffed it up with a well done. There you go. Dealt with those guys. Rather than having to try and dodge them on a step, you know. Thank you. I would like some fodder for Sparks because poor old Sparks here is very not happy. Oh, thanks for not moving. You would have been very difficult to catch with two health. So I think the game might have had a little minor hiccup there, but I'll take it. Careful, get rid of the big guys first. Then he's simple. Oh, is that 25? Jesus, he's worth a lot. Hello, Lucas.
Listen carefully, Spyro. There's a secret area in the artisan's home world near the waterfall. Try jumping on the stones there.
Artisan's home world? Waterfall. Sounds good.
Everyone knows that, man. Right, okay. That's what unlocks Sunny Flight, I think it's called. Is there really no fodder in this world? Have I accidentally come to the boss world or something? Nah, can't be. Alright, okay, well, the next step here is to start doing the glide. I think there might not be much fodder here because the main threat of this world isn't really the enemies. It's more so if you fluff up a charge, you end up falling into a giant hole. So we'll take the save point and then we'll try doing these charge jumps. How successful we'll be, I don't know. Miss. This world needed the fairies, not the other one. Oh, you've got to have faith that you're going to get enough speed to do it, enough momentum. Okay, that's cool. Well, let me get all these gems up here then. And hopefully they've not changed this egg thief, because this egg thief does not actually run away. It just hides her like a bit of a plum. Excellent. Alright, cool. Let's get... Okay, I'm not sure what that was all about, but there you go. What I need to do is get the charge jump over here now, so... I'll give that a go. Starting from up here. Got it. Perfect. So harsh putting all the gems up here, man. And then the final bit of this world is... there's an exterior bit somewhere. It's not here, clearly. The exterior bit's at the start of a world, which... I always forget about, and I always have no idea how to get there. But who puts chargey chests on top of this precarious pillar? So we've got the bad bits. And I don't think this has anything to do with charge jumping anymore, now that we've got all those gems. Oh boy. Then let's go up here and see if there's a little nook I can get around. No, okay, I'll show you what I mean. So, we're coming back up to the start of a level. And there's that guy up there. So, we need to figure out how to get to him. It's around the rooftop area. I think you can come... you see there's like, oh, there's a platforming over there. I think you might need to glide from the very start of a level. It's nothing to do with it being on the interior. At least I don't think it is. What I think you've got to do is come here and... I don't think you can glide around to the right, but you can see there's this little area here. And a lot of the stuff I've got to do comes from here. Right, excellent. So, let's just make our way through this particular patch. This is where I struggle to remember exactly what it is I've got to do. I think it is just a very linear path, though. Not many enemies to speak of. Is there any enemies over here? No, just gems. I slide onto this rooftop and come over here. Oh, this is where all the fodder is for this world. It's up here. Can land down there, or there has to be something here. I need to get down there, but I'm concerned that I need to glide somewhere to get to an enemy. It's over there somewhere, I think. I don't know. Right, let me just go get those gems and then I'll see about figuring it out. I think it is another one of those Leap of Faith glides that I've got to do. That tests your knowledge of the world. Oh, come on, man. That was the camera being a bit dodgy there, I think. Should have just taken a bit more time to prepare that jump. I'll come back to you when I get there. Oh, I'll just glide from the top. That makes more sense. Yeah, you're a dead man. And what I need to do now is I want to get back up there. So I'll meet you back at the top. And what I'm going to do is I'm above the place of the bridge. Rather than gliding over there, I'm going to, from here, do a Leap of Faith glide. There we go. Is that it? Excellent! Leap of Faith glides, man. You've got to have faith in it sometimes. And now we can move on to the next particular level. Which, actually, I think we've done all the levels now in... all the, like, main levels in Magic Crafters, so... What we need to do next is complete gathering all the gems and dragons and eggs or whatever in the hub world itself, and then we'll move on to the flight level. And that's where we're going to have to end it because we're out of time for this video today, unfortunately. So yeah, Wizard's Peak was, it actually looks, obviously, it looks a lot better than the original, but again, it just seemed to have that bit more personality that was missing in the original. Like, in the original, it sort of had those purpley, you know, twilight, colours to it, but they really were a lot more fleshed out in this particular game, so I love that sort of, is it twilight? It's the one where it's like right on the cusp of sunset or like really early in the morning. It just seems to have that appeal to the level and it gave it its own character, you know. So yeah, next episode we'll continue on with Magic Crafters. I think we're on to the boss level actually, if I'm not mistaken, or at the very least the flight level. So we'll stick on with that next episode. Anyway, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.